In 1849, William Penn Abrams got himself lost while tracking a bear and came upon a valley enclosed by stupendous cliffs rising some 3,000 feet above its base. This was the first sighting by a white man of the Valley of the Yosemite Indians. Our lost bear tracker took note of the number of waterfalls sliding down these high cliffs into the valley. Here, the Bridalveil train bellows out in the fickle and changing breezes. Now there is a migration every summer from all parts of the world to take in this valley of wonder and to gaze at this icon of Yosemite National Park, 2,425-foot Yosemite Falls, 9 times as high as Niagara. But not all of the valley is one roaring cascade of water upon rocks. There is much that is quiet and reflective. An upside-down view of Mount Watkins is realized on aptly named Mirror Lake. There are a number of trails out of the valley to the rim, but for those not ready to take that hike, a drive to Glacier Point can provide a bird's eye view of Yosemite Falls and all below. But there is more to see and learn from this location. Mr. Abrams, our original visitor, noted that a rounded mountain stood as though as it had been sliced, as one would slice a loaf of bread. Today it is a familiar landmark, recognized far and wide as Half Dome. But as seen here from Glacier Point, it is what is beyond this monolith that can heighten our interest. As one drives up into the high country of Yosemite along the Tioga Pass Highway, the only road through the park, one is flabbergasted by the sheer, immense size opening up to the eye of range upon range of blue granite mountain peaks. These are joined together, yet separated by valleys of forest, meadows, and shimmering mountain lakes. This lake is just west of near 10,000-foot Tioga Pass, the eastern entrance to the park. The highway leads us to a favorite stopping-off place in the park, or maybe I should say a starting-off place. Though closed by winter snows at 8,600 feet elevation, during the high summer months, Tuolumne Meadows provides a rich and breathtaking change for those who venture up here. Here, you get out of the car, place one foot in front of the other, and find a new world opening up to your eyes. One can partake in a ranger-interpreted hike of from 1 hour to 5 days, a way to see the park in its pristine mode. A good pair of shoes, a bit of energy, and off you go. A stop along the way while our guide provides us an insight of the topography around us, and to catch our breath for those sea level dwellers not used to the thinner air of over 8,000 foot elevation. We ascend 850 feet in 1.5 miles of hiking to Conquer Lambert Dome at a height of 9,450 feet. I guess this was rock climbing, easy tourist style of the 1970s. A distinct feature of the Yosemite area is the domes that have been rounded and polished by the overriding glacial action of eons ago. Here the trail disappears, and it's now just a mad scramble to get to the top. And all comes to a halt as we gaze upon a limitless expanse of the high Sierra Mountains of Yosemite. It's a toss-up as to whether our breathlessness is that of the climb or the view. More easy walking. A 1 mile hike brings us to one of the many quiet lakes in the Meadows area. A bit of fishing, or just enjoying a time of reflection, Dog Lake fills the bill. A bit more walking, let's say 6 miles all downhill from the trailhead, brings us to Tuolumne Falls. Of a different nature of that of Yosemite Falls, this roaring cascade will send your head spinning and your heart pounding. As previously stated, Tuolumne Falls is reached by 6 miles of trail, downhill. So, a reverse of the old axiom, what goes down must come back up, to return to the trailhead. Yosemite High Country, accessible only in the summer. Most of the tourists to the valley miss it completely. Yet it is by taking that hike up to the timberline area that you really come to feel the wonder here. Here you slow down, stop, look, and find what your eyes missed from the roadway. The small and the delicate vie for your attention, turning your attention momentarily from the wide panoramic sweep. It is midsummer, but here summer has an uphill battle asserting itself. Climb some more and soon you find the world at your feet. You have walked long and climbed hard to reach this plateau, only to find that you are dwarfed by the limitless grandeur before you. You gaze about you and realize you can never conquer. You are only here on sufferance. The Meadows of the River Tuolumne of Yosemite. Something to always retain in the mind's eye. The aftermath of a high Sierra storm. The flaming riot of watercolor of the setting sun. And you know this sunset is only a prelude to the next day, when you will find yourself not conqueror, but conquered by the magnificence of the peaks, valleys, and lakes of the Yosemite High Sierra.